Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success, an online free educational institute. So this video is presented by me, Shirshendu Mitra, research scholar of Indian Institute of Technology, Goa. So in this video, I'll tell something about important appointments that has happened in India in 2016. So this video is made by collecting information from various news reports, articles and several websites such as Wikipedia and other official websites of several organizations. Therefore, we do not claim any originality of this video. We acknowledge all the source data have been collected from. Any copyright infringement has not been made during the compilation of the video with the best of our knowledge and experience. So let us start. So Mr. Girish Gupta, Chief Justice of Calcutta High Court, you can see he has MA LLB degree and was born on December 1, 1954. He was enrolled as an advocate on September 20, 1982 and practiced in the Calcutta High Court for the last 17 years in civil, constitutional, company, arbitration and commercial matters. He was appointed as a permanent judge of Calcutta High Court on September 15, 2000. Initially, he was appointed as an acting Chief Justice of the Calcutta High Court on August 22, 2016, but later on, government has decided to make him the permanent Chief Justice of Calcutta High Court, and that has happened on September 21, 2016. So let us talk about a few things on Calcutta High Court. The Calcutta High Court is the oldest High Court of India. It was established on 1st July 1862 under the High Courts Act that passed in the year 1861. It has jurisdiction not only over the entire state of West Bengal but also the Union Territory of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. The High Court building was designed by Mr. Walter, and one more important thing, that is the number of judges now they are in the High Court, that is Calcutta High Court, is 72. So this man, he has been selected as a whole time member of SEBI. Initially he was the RBI, he was a member of RBI executive director. Now he has been appointed for 5 years or till age of 65, whichever comes early. He will get a consolidated salary of 3.75 lakh, an order issued by Department of Personnel and Training, that is the Department of Government of India. They have issued a notification mentioning this facts. So moving forward, something about SEBI. The SEBI means Securities and Exchange Board of India, and that was established on April 12, 1992, in accordance with the provisions of Securities and Exchange Board of India Act 1992. And initially, the SEBI was a non-statutory body without any statutory power, but later on, in 1995, SEBI was given additional statutory power by Government of India through some amendment act. So this man, we all know, Ratan Tata, he has been selected as interim chairman of Tata Sons after sudden replacement or sudden termination of Cyrus Mistry. You all know, because this was in news for last few days. Now Ratan Tata is 78 and he quit in 2012, and again he has been selected as an interim chairman. Arundhati Bhattacharya, we all know that she was SBI chairman for last 2 years, and government has extended her tenure for another year, and that extension was announced on 7th October, last month itself. Okay, few things about State Bank of India. State Bank of India is an Indian multinational public sector banking and financial service company, and it has its headquarters in Mumbai, Maharashtra, And this is a Fortune, this is a Fortune 500 company. Its rank is 232. Yeah, this man S. Shiv Kumar appointed as a permanent member of 21st Law Commission of India LCI. So 21st Law Commission of India was set up by Union Government, and few things to be noted here. Why did this Law Commission started? What would be their agenda? What they will be doing in their tenure? And that commission will work till 31st August 2018. So, and this man was the former Chief Justice, former Supreme Court judge, and now selected as a member of Law Commission. And the agenda given to this Law Commission are major recommendations on review of Indian Penal Code, the criminal justice system and bail law in order to ensure uniformity in the procedure of granting the relief. So those things that these people will be doing during this tenure. So something about Law Commission. Law Commission of India is an executive body established by an order of Government of India. Its major function is to work for legal reform. Its membership primarily comprises legal experts who are entrusted a mandate by the government. The commission is established for a fixed tenure and works as an advisory body to the Ministry of Law and Justice. You all know that is a ministry under Government of India. So MS Sahu, this man who was till recently Competition Commission of India's members, but now he elected as the chairman of IBBI. What is the full form of IBBI? Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. So that is enough for now. You all know PV Sindhu. She was in last Olympic that happened in Brazil, Rio de Janeiro, 2016 Olympic, and she bagged silver medal, and now she appointed as ambassador of Vizag Steel Plant. So this is a great man, because he can say he's the best diplomat in the world now, because he is the chairman of United Nations General Assembly. So initially he was a former Prime Minister of Portuguese, and now appointed as UN General Secretary. Before him, Ban Ki-moon was the United Nations General Secretary, and he completed his tenure to second 5-year term. And so Ban Ki-moon was there for last 10 years. Now he will be taking care of, he already taken care of the United Nations General Assembly's chairman. So something about United Nations. United Nations is an intergovernmental organization to promote international cooperation. A replacement for the ineffective League of Nations, the organization was established on 24th October 1945 after the World War in order to prevent another such conflict. So main agenda was to make peace, to unite the whole world, not to fight once again. It is at its founding, the UN had 51 member states. There are now 193. So it started with 51 members, now it has 193 members. The headquarters of United Nations is in New York City, Manhattan. And experiences extraterritoriality. What is that one? So far the main offices are situated in Geneva, Nairobi and Vienna. So it has several offices, and those are the offices of those. The organization is financed by assessed and voluntary contributions from its member states. Its objective includes maintaining international peace and security, promoting human rights, fostering social and economic development, protecting environment, and providing humanitarian aid in cases of famine, natural disaster, and armed conflict. So, Overall, you can say United Nations work to maintain peace throughout the world, and that is a great organization working for the entire world. So you should learn more about United Nations. You can go to the United Nations website and you can have idea. So this man, he has been elected as Morocco's prime minister, and he was the prime minister of Morocco. He appointed for the second, not appointed, elected for the second term, Abdelilah Ben Irane, that is the name. So next, this person is Ajay Kumar Bhalla. He was a senior IAS officer. Now he has been selected as Director General of DGFT. What is DGFT? Directorate General of Foreign Trade. He will succeed Anu Vadhavan, who has been appointed as Additional Secretary in the Union Ministry of Commerce. He is a 1984 batch IAS officer of Assam and Meghalaya cadre. Presently, he is Additional Secretary in the Union Ministry of Commerce. So something about DGFT. DGFT is a nodal agency of Union Ministry of Commerce and Industry, responsible for execution of import and export policies of India. So that is the main thing what it does. It does the work of import and export policies. It is entrusted with responsibilities for formulating and implementing the foreign trade policy with the main objective of promoting India's exports. So that is enough for DGFT for the purposes of this video. So this man, he has been elected as Chief Justice. He was the Chief Justice of High Court. His name is Bilal Nasgi. Now he has been appointed as Chairperson of State Human Rights Commission for the state of Jammu Kashmir. So that is enough for him. This man has been appointed as Odisha's Chief Information Commissioner. His name is Sunil Kumar Misra. So, a notification in this regard was issued by Information and Public Relations Department following approval of Misra's name by the Governor's S.C. Jami on Wednesday. So, this man is the Governor of Odisha and he has been selected as CIC of Odisha. And something about CIC, this is basically related to Right to Information Act 2005. What happened actually in the bill or the act itself, it is written for the purposes of for the working of RTI, there would be a commission named Central Investigations and Chief Information Commissioner for each state, and there will be a chairperson of that commission, and he has been appointed for that for the state of Odisha. So this man Sushil Chandra, he was a senior IRS officer, Indian Revenue Service officer, now appointed as chairman of CBDT, Central Board of Direct Taxes. So you should know in this regard that in general senior IRS officer only holds this post, that is chairman of CBDT. So before him, this man was the chairman of CBDT, Rani Singh Nair. So he replaces Rani Singh Nair. Something about him, he was a 1980 batch Indian Revenue Service officer, income tax cadre. So this girl, Saina Nehwal, you all know. Saina Nehwal appointed as a member of IOC's Athlete Commissions in rare honor for Indians. So Indians do not get this honor, but she managed to get it somehow, and there is something about Saina Nehwal. So she managed to have 2 gold in Commonwealth 2010 and 2008, bronze in 2006 Commonwealth, and silver in 2004 Commonwealth. So that is all about Saina Nehwal. So this man, Dr. Jim Yong Kim, who is this man? This man is the executive director of World Bank. And he will actually he only was the last executive director of World Bank. So again he got the second term, and his second term would start from July 1, 2017. So something about World Bank. World Bank is an international financial institution that provides loan to developing countries for capital programs. It comprises two institutions, International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, IBRD, and the International Development Association, IDA. The World Bank is a component of World Bank Group, which is part of United Nations system. So this much is enough for World Bank. So this man is Junaid Ahmed, has taken over as World Bank's new country director for India, replacing Onno Ruhul, who completed his four-year term. So by national, he was a Bangladeshi. So those are the important appointments as per my view, and some more you have to know, and that I have taken in this box. Shakti Sinha, he will be taking charge of Director of Nehru Memorial Museum and Library. Deepanjan Bosu has been selected for CFO of Myntra. R. Subramania Kumar, this man has been selected as or appointed as Director of Overseas Bank. So few more appointments that announced in this month, that is December 2016 itself, that is Research and Analysis Wing, RAW, Anil Dasmana, Senior IPS Officer, 1981 batch, Madhya Pradesh cadre. Previously this post was held by Rajinder Khanna. So Chief, next COAS, Chief of Army Staff. So Bipin Rath has been appointed for the next COAS, and Dalbir Singh is holding the post. His tenure is 31st December 2016. So after that Bipin Rath will be taking charge. Then Chief of Intelligence Bureau, Rajiv Jain, IPS Officer of 1985 Jharkhand cadre, has been appointed as the Chief of Intelligence Bureau. Previously this post was held by Dinesh Sharma. Then Air Chief of IAF, Birender Singh Dhana, Air Marshal. Previously this post was held by Arun Praha. Then Chief Justice of India, 44th Chief Justice of India, Jagdish Singh Kheher. Initially, previously this post was held by T.S. Thakur. Moving forward, so those are the appointments, in my view, important for the purposes of examinations and for your general knowledge as well. And those are many more appointments that has been taken from various websites. So one thing I can recommend you, so General Knowledge Today is a good website to know general knowledge, to learn general knowledge. So you can have data from various sources, but this video is made to tell you what are the important appointments, and that I have covered in this video. So thank you for watching my video. And one more thing, please visit to our blogging website. That is this website, you can type this in your browser and you can check our blogs. So we generally upload blogs also, we write blogs on several similar kind of things. Please see our blogs and comment. Thank you very much.